President Trump is showing no sign of backing down, tweeting in all caps, "We will win," and ballot counting abuse.
He may be tweeting up a storm, but he hasn't been seen in public since last Thursday.
As far as I can recall, this is the longest that we have gone without seeing the president come out and chat with us.
Multiple Trump allies and advisors say the president is spiraling into rage and hurting his own legacy, as well as the Republican Party.
Joe Biden reacted today at a press conference.
I just think it's an embarrassment, quite frankly. I think it will not help the president's legacy.
Trump is reportedly doing what he can to block the Biden team from an orderly transition.
They're not allowed to get access to the funds that they need to run the transition process. Joe Biden not getting his daily security, highly classified security briefings.
And he's lashing out at Fox News after Neil Cavuto cut away from White House Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany as she was making unfounded claims that Democrats had rigged the election.
We want every legal vote to be counted, and we want every illegal vote.
I just think we have to be very clear. She's charging the other side is welcoming fraud and welcoming illegal voting. Unless she has more details to back that up, I can't in good countenance continue showing you this.
But Fox's Sean Hannity is still solidly in Trump's corner.
And people are actually saying things that say impropriety they witnessed and were a part of, and people, they watched it with their own eyes. Should they not be listened to?
Today, he's promoting a March for Trump rally in D.C. on Saturday, which organizers are calling the largest Trump rally of all time. And there are reports today that the president's son, Don Jr., and his girlfriend, Kimberly Guilfoyle, are plotting a takeover of the Republican Party.
Several GOP sources are telling CNN that the president's eldest son, Donald Trump Jr., and his girlfriend, Kimberly Guilfoyle, are right now making moves to expand their influence in the RNC.
But Don Jr. responded fake news as usual, adding that he has zero interest in the job. Meanwhile, Whoopi Goldberg has an edgy message for Trump voters.
All of you, suck it up. Suck it up like we sucked it up.
In New York, store owners are removing the plywood boards they put up in anticipation of election rioting that fortunately never happened. But across the USA, passions are still running high. One woman had her mask ripped off by a Trump supporter in Pensacola. This guy in a headlock was charged with reckless driving after he allegedly tried to disrupt a Stop the Steal car parade in California.
Welcome to MAGA country.
And this tow truck driver is accused of refusing to help two Joe Biden supporters who found themselves stranded on the side of a road.
He works for AAA.
He refused service to us for our Biden bumper sticker, said the driver who posted the video on TikTok. You can see the Biden sign in this photo.
The first words he said to me was, "I do not know if I want to serve someone who has those kinds of beliefs."
Julian Weiss and Nate Dollarhide say they called AAA to fix a tire on one of their cars on a trip to Oregon.
It was pretty clear after a few times that after, you know, a few moments later that he was pretty dead set on driving away and not helping.
AAA investigated the allegation, saying in a statement, "The driver will no longer be working with AAA. We deeply regret the experience and inconvenience to the member." The tow truck company could not be reached for comment.
He works for AAA.
AAA immediately investigated after the video was circulated on Twitter, and they say they will not tolerate that kind of behavior.